Hi everyone, you welcome to Showbiz Arena on Eshala TV. Eshala TV are bigger than ever. SL TV at Oshukume. I'm Queen Esther, your host for today's interview. Our guest for today is a UK-based artist, a professional and versatile entertainer, an acrobat, a dance teacher, a musician, a circus skills performer, and an artist director. He has won the African Culture Excellency Award in UK 2017. He's a hit maker of Itole Song and the trending song titled Emo Song. Ladies and gentlemen, before I introduce you to our guest for today, let's go for a quick commercial break and we'll be right back.
Yo, this is your boy Bismarck the Joker. Come here, back up. Come on, keep watching Eshala TV. Ninke agbushi come call Joanne. Provide them. No battle number three. The joke says so. Come here, back up.
You welcome back. Our guest today is Emmanuel Okan, aka One You, the Magnificent. One You, you welcome.
Queen Esther.
Yes.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Oh, I'm not bad. I'm better than nothing.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm better than nothing.
Alright. So, who is Wang Yu?
Wang Yu. Yeah, I am Wang Yu. A lot of people don't know where that name comes from. But that name was given to me by my uncle, my mom's younger brother. But he just passed away, may he so rest in peace.
Okay, so why that name? Why is it called?
He gave it to me. I think when I was young, I was very bubbly, you know, and I was very active, you know, and I just do all kinds of things. I like dancing. I like to be in action. So you know, those days, I was young, so I don't know anything. I did go and watch films. I think that's where I picked that name from, this Chinese actor, Wang Yu. You know, when he watched Kung Fu fights and all that. So he came and started giving us name in the house. So we have Kung Fu, we have Mother India and everything. But I'm Wang Yu.
Okay, cool. So, so what's your inspiration behind your hit song?
I'm glad that at least, you know, I've started something. It's a vision that I saw. Because I'm a gun and I like to be original and I like to do what I feel comfortable. When I get my inspiration and I'm writing, I can express myself more in my language, which is the Ghana language. So when I see people dancing, and when I started, people not used to me, a little while, and I have to work hard and push it. With the support from other artists and friends who are also supporting me in the student things, you know, and the fans, you know, especially the people in the coastal area from, let's say, I would say, Nyanyan, all the way to Adan, you know, my music trained more in the coast, so the southern part of Accra here. Yeah. Now, my music is everywhere. They play in America, everywhere, all over the world. So I'm glad when I see my people dancing to our traditional, authentic, you know, music, singing in the dialect. Yeah, that's where, you know, I like it more. Yeah.
Okay. So how long have you been in the music industry?
I've been in the music industry for 10 years, you know, because my first album was, I recorded my first album in 2007. Okay. Yeah, that was the first time I came out with an album called Condom. Wow, that was the first experience. I launched it and everything. Then, yeah, so I've been there for 10 years in the music. But I've been an artist for, a long time. A long, long time, yeah.
Okay, so what type of music do you
do? I do traditional music, alive. I can play Afrobeat, I play reggae. I'm versatile. I do all kinds of music. I play soul. You know, but more in my language, which is my girl language. Yeah, I like singing in my language. Just sometimes I sing a bit of English or three, you know, in between. But most is, I would say, Ghana life. Yeah, more like Ghana.
Have you made a lot of money in music
career? I will make money as money, you know, but I'm okay because I don't just do music. I'm an artist. and I'm successful in what I do, not only financially, or when I say not only money, you understand, but I'm successful in what I do. When I walk around, people know me. The music has opened a lot of ways for me, you know. Yes, a lot of doors has opened for me when I go to so many places, you know. And I'm okay. I won't say money, but I'm okay. I'm not poor. I won't call myself rich or mega rich, but I'm okay. I like my lifestyle. You know, just but I don't come out with what I have. You know, I just think I'm okay. Yeah, I'm successful. I thank God. Because not everybody will get what I have.
Yeah.
I travel everywhere. I go all over places. You know, I still perform all over countries. I still get paid. You know, I do my other businesses and stuff like that. So, rich is not what rich. I can be rich inside. And I said, when I walk, I feel proud. I'm rich because when I see people play my music and it's giving positive change, you know, that's what I call it, rich. I'm not looking for only material kind of riches. You understand? So I'm rich inside. I'm rich. Rich man.
Okay, so let's continue. What are some of the challenges you face in your music career?
Oh, that one is huge. In this business, if you don't take care, you will quit. Yeah, the competition is huge. But the reason why I'm not facing too much challenges is like, that's why I said from the beginning, I do my own thing, like original. I just create and I do what I think I'm comfortable. I don't try to do things that people are doing. There are people who want to sing other songs because they think, oh, these are the songs that are trendy. There is market for everything that you do if you do it well. You understand? So the challenges there, they are there. The most challenging things, like if I would say, is maybe having a very good manager to really manage you well for your videos, your, you know, shows and things like that, so that people will like know you more in, you know, in all, and giving you very good shows, big stages. I do a lot of big shows, sharing big platforms with a lot of celebrities worldwide. Although I'm from Ghana, because I've lived in Ghana, and since I left Ghana, I come home every year. But then I don't do most shows like here. What I do here is like 5% compared to UK or, you know, international. Yeah, so what I do here is late. Yeah, when I come here, I don't do my acrobatics and my juggling and other stuff. I just focus on the music here. But when I'm in the UK, I do everything. You understand?
Yeah. So, who's your favorite artist?
I am my own favorite artist.
Okay.
Oh, I love a lot of artists, reggae artists. I can never stop mentioning them. Everybody is good. You understand? Depend on the mood and the kind of music you want to listen to. In Ghana, yeah, there's a lot of people who are doing well in the music industry. If I say I want to mention, it will be like I'm trying to defamatize somebody, so I don't want to mention anybody. But big up to everybody who is doing well in the music industry. Yeah.
Okay. So since you're based in the UK,
yeah,
do you have any collaboration or you featuring somebody international?
Not much. I've worked with people on sharing the same platform, and I've worked with a lot of big artists, you know, together on the same stage. Like Youssou N'Dou from Senegal, I've worked with Bunju, who were in Spain. In the summer, around August, we were in Spain. I worked with Youssou N'Dou at the Mobile Award. I've done Millennium Dome with some celebrities before they changed it to call it O2. I've done Royal Festival Hall. I've been to Britain's Got Talent. I've done a lot of shows. Been to Dubai Shopping Festival. I've been to America. I've traveled a lot and I've performed on big theaters and festivals and many more. Yeah, in the UK when it comes to collaboration, yeah, I featured Sonny Bali. He's one of the dancehall artists. In the UK, I've had a song with him called Mijo Sofule. He's German, very, very nice. Yeah, Yeah, but not much in the music. But when it comes to the art and all, then I've done a lot with people. But in the music, I haven't featured a lot of international artists there yet. When I was in Spain, I met Beanie Man, Chronix, and so many celebrities, some from Jamaica. And so we went to a festival called the Rototo. Yeah, it's a big festival, the biggest reggae festival in Europe. And they host it there. They always do it in Spain. Yeah, and then they call artists from around the world. Yeah.
So do you have an album?
Oh yeah, I got a couple of albums. My first album is Condom. Second album was a hit. That was the Tole. And up to now, every event. Etole, lala tole, ete shimanke, etolo chokba dani chunena. Hey, Eta! Evergreen! Listen to Ngoso, a band of life!
Okay, on what platform have you performed both internationally and locally?
You mean, in Ghana, I used to perform, I've done a lot of shows in the National Theatre, Stadium, Art Center, and many more. In the UK and worldwide, I work in the community, schools. I even work in detention centers because we have I have an organization called Music for Change. It goes to work with detainees and stuff like that. People who have maybe immigration issues and, you know, problems and that. They lock them in the prison. We go and do music workshops and things. I work in a lot of universities, going to teach Africa culture and stuff like that, teaching drumming and dance and many more. I also work with circles, so I travel with them sometimes. We work all over UK, festivals and many more. Then I travel also to abroad, like other countries, Spain, Dubai, all over, you know, so I'm everywhere. Huge theatres, Royal National Festival Hall, I can't even remember, it's too much. Yeah, I get very busy when I'm in the UK. Very busy. Yeah, if you don't book me early, you won't get me. Yeah, I get very busy. Weddings, parties, you name them. Yeah, whatever.
Okay, so you perform alone or young group?
Yes, I've got two groups there. One is called UK African Acrobats. I'm the leader, I'm the founder. African Stars Band. So when I get shows, I put African artists together to come together for us to work as stars. So all the stars in UK that I know them, I bring them, I invite them, we rehearse and we go and do shows. So I call the band UK African Stars Band. And then my acrobatic group, as well, I call it UK African Acrobats. But when I'm going to work on my own, then I use Imanoloka, aka Wanyu the Magnificent. So I work on my own as well, I do solo shows. I teach and I also perform as solo. So it depends on the booking. You understand? Yeah. I do kids entertainment, children entertainment. I do festivals. I work all over. I also do one-to-one lessons. If you want me to teach you something, like, I will teach you. It will take you 3 years, like going to school.
So what's your opinion on Ghanaian artists and your little advice?
Things are doing well. I like all kinds of song. Dancehall, high life, reggae, gospel, bashing. Everything that they are doing is good. Our song should educate the youth coming.
So, any shout out?
Shout out to man like Eddie, Extra Large, you know, Abokome, to Queen Esther, to my friend, King Jerry, you know, to King Jerry, I know Extra Large, so you know, I have to mention King Jerry. King Jerry, big up to you wherever you are. Big up to women like Ojeko and Niyaya 531 of Gadangbe, the president of Gadangbe. Big up to women like Remedy, yeah! All the way in London. Big up to women like Gaff. Big up to women like Sami Superstar. Big up to all the bands like Ulome. And big up to women like Achu, Jacob Achu Latevi, and all my friends.
Ha ha ha.
Emmanuel Oka, aka Why You the Magnificent. Hey, Yeta! Ewa!
I'm basically not trouble, no.
This show was kindly brought to you by Obia Beads and Makeup. Obia Beads and Makeup, customer satisfaction is our priority. For all your professional makeup, weddings, and photo shoots, you can contact Obia Beads and Makeup on the number on your screen. Until we come your way, same next time, it's bye from your queen, Queen Esther.